Hello dear students, welcome to BioLearn, the YouTube channel for online biology learning. I am Akshay Dave, your biology facilitator. In this video, you will learn about epithelial tissues in animals, which form the outer and inner layers of the body. So, let's start learning right away. In animals, epithelial tissue or epithelium constitutes a continuous layer of cells on the entire body surface, inside the body cavities, and all the passages leading to the exterior, such as nasal cavity, mouth cavity, anus, and genital openings. If we look at the structure of epithelium, it is a continuous layer of tightly packed cells with negligible or no intercellular space between the cells. The cells rest upon a non-cellular basement membrane made up of proteins. This tissue lacks blood vessels. If we look at the functions of epithelium, it is mainly a protective tissue. It protects the underlying cells from the adverse environmental conditions such as dryness, injury, and entry of pathogens. It also protects the body cavities and hollow organs from mechanical trauma. It helps in absorption of substances in the alimentary canal. A few cells are secretory, such as the cells of the salivary glands, sweat glands, and endocrine glands. Some cells, like the cells of taste buds, nose, and the ear, also assist in nerve transmission. The epithelial tissue can be simple epithelium, which consists of a single layer of cells, or it can be stratified or compound epithelium, which consists of two or more layers of cells. On the basis of structure and function of the cells, epithelial tissue can be of the following types. Squamous epithelium is made up of a thin layer of flat cells, each with a centrally located nucleus. It forms the delicate inner lining of blood vessels, heart, mouth, and nose. It protects the underlying parts and facilitates the movement in internal organs. It also forms a selectively permeable surface through which filtration takes place. Cuboidal epithelium consists of cuboidal cells, which have a centrally located spherical nucleus. It forms the lining of kidney tubules, duct of sweat glands, alveoli of lungs, thyroid vesicles, and germinal layer of the ovaries. It is a mechanical tissue and also helps in absorption, excretion, and secretion. Columnar epithelium consists of tall, elongated, rectangular cells with a basal oval nucleus. The cells may have a striated border, which increases their surface area. It forms the lining of the stomach, intestine, gallbladder, and oviducts. It facilitates the movement of substances and thus helps in absorption as well as secretion. Glandular epithelium consists of columnar or cuboidal cells, which are specialized for secretory functions. The glandular cells are found in the endocrine glands, sebaceous glands, and salivary glands. These secrete various chemical substances. They may also synthesize them and store in the cells. Ciliated epithelium consists of cuboidal or columnar cells with cilia on their free surface. It is mainly present in the linings of the uterus, oviducts, respiratory tract, parts of middle ear, and testes. The ciliated cells move particles or mucus over the epithelium in a specific direction by the ciliary motion. In the oviducts, these cells guide the ova to the uterus, while in the respiratory tract, cilia move the mucus over the epithelial surface. So, If you find my videos useful, then hit that like button. Share this video with your fellow students and let me know your thoughts in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit that bell icon to get all the future notifications of videos. See you all in the next video.